Hey everyone, this is Sandeep here from 99signals.com. I'm back with another AppSumo deal review. And in this video, I'll be doing a review and walkthrough of Social Snap, which is a WordPress social media plugin. We all know the importance of driving traffic from social media. In fact, one of the first things we do when we publish a new piece of content is to share it on different social networks. Now, with a tool like Social Snap, you'll be making it easier for users to share your content on different networks. Social Snap contains a host of social media features, but one of its main features is that it lets you add social media share buttons to different pages on your site. These buttons are 100% customizable and can even blend naturally with your site's design. Now, there are a lot of WordPress plugins out there, some of them free, which allow you to add social media buttons to different pages on your site. But most of them are messy, difficult to set up, and can even slow your website down. And we all know how important site speed is when it comes to ranking your pages in search engine result pages. Social Snap, on the other hand, is easy to set up, as you'll see in the walkthrough. It doesn't affect your site speed, and the social media buttons blend incredibly well alongside your content. Now, if you're watching this at a time when the AppSumo deal is live, you can click the link in the description. You'll be taken to the AppSumo deal page, and you can get lifetime access to Social Snap's agency plan for $39. Now, this plan usually goes for $299 a year, but with AppSumo, you can get lifetime access to it for just $39. If you're watching this video at a time when the AppSumo deal has been sold out, then you have no option but to go to socialsnap.com and check out any of their plans. The cheapest plan that they have starts from $39 a year, and you can only add Social Snap to just one site as compared to 15 sites that you get with the AppSumo deal. Now, before I start the walkthrough, I'll be doing a quick rundown of everything that's included in the AppSumo plan. You can skip this section if you have already activated this plan from AppSumo, or if you purchased this directly from their site and you'd just like to see how it's set up and how it integrates with your site. You can skip this section. You'll find all the relevant timestamps in the description. But for those of you who are not aware of the AppSumo deal and what's included in it, I would urge you to watch it. So this is the Social Snap deal page on AppSumo, and the deal has been live for a couple of weeks. And, you know, I'll be uploading this video on 12th or 13th of Jan. So I'm not sure how long this deal will be live. It'll probably be live till the end of Jan 2020. So by the end of this video, if you're really impressed with the product, then you can click the link in the description, go to the AppSumo page and get yourself a lifetime deal. And by doing that, you'll be saving a lot of money on your subscription of Social Snap. Let me just quickly explain what you get with the AppSumo deal. So the plan that they're offering is the agency plan. This is the plan that is currently on offer at AppSumo. You'll be getting all of these when you buy the AppSumo deal. Right now, Social Snap itself is running a 30% offer. And even with 30% off, you would still have to pay $209 per year if you want to subscribe to the agency plan. With AppSumo, on the other hand, you can get lifetime access to it for $39. Now, with the agency plan, you install and activate Social Snap on 15 of your sites. If you have an agency or if you have a lot of affiliate sites, then you can get an even better ROI for this deal that you're buying at AppSumo. So with Social Snap, you can add up to 30 plus share providers. So these are all the share buttons that you can activate via Social Snap on your website. So aside from Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Pinterest, you can also add additional buttons like WhatsApp, Facebook Messenger, Yahoo, Skype, or even Reddit. So all of these options are available to you. So I'll show you how to activate these when I'm doing the walkthrough. But based on where you would like to increase your engagement, you can add all these share buttons on your website and make it easier for users who visit your website to share your content on different channels. In addition to these, you'll also be getting social follow buttons. You'll get a click to tweet widget, and you'll also be getting a few add-ons. I'll show you how to set up all of these functionalities on your site when I'm doing the Social Snap walkthrough. But right now, you just need to know this is what you'll be getting with the AppSumo deal. You can get lifetime access to Social Snap for $39. To be precise, you'll be getting lifetime access to the agency plan, where you can add up to 15 sites. On a regular day, you would have to pay $299 per year for this plan. But with AppSumo, you can get access to the agency plan for just $39. That's 87% off. So you can do the math of how much money you'll be saving by going for this deal on AppSumo. Like I said, if you're impressed with this product when I complete the walkthrough, you can click the link in the description, go to the AppSumo page and get yourself a lifetime deal while it's still available. So now we'll be starting the walkthrough of Social Snap. So that's coming up next. So I've just logged into my Social Snap account, and this is the dashboard. And once you have your AppSumo code, you would probably need to create an account with Social Snap. And once you have done that, you can download the plugin, which you can see right here. You just need to click on the download button, and a zipped file will be downloaded onto your system. Next thing that you need to do is log into your WordPress site, and then just install this plugin. Click on Add New, and then just upload the plugin, upload the zipped file, and activate your plugin. Once it's activated, you can see Social Snap right on your dashboard itself. The first thing that you need to do is activate the license that you received with your AppSumo deal, and just click on License. Just copy this particular license key and paste it here. And once you've done that, once you've verified your key, your site will be activated. And as you know, you'll get 15 activations with your Social Snap plan, the one that you buy at AppSumo. And if you have a digital marketing agency or you run a lot of affiliate sites, then this deal would be even more valuable to you. So let's get back to Social Snap now. So once you have activated your license, you are all set to start using Social Snap. Just go to the Settings tab. So the plugin will be mainly used for social sharing. So we'll start with that. The first thing that you need to do is manage the networks. Now, these are all the networks that will be visible on your social bar. And you'll be seeing some of the obvious ones already activated on your account. Social networks like Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn. You can add more networks here. You have the option to add up to 30 social networks on your social bar. And you can activate the ones where you would like to increase engagement. But don't add too many social networks, because then your social bar will look pretty cluttered and you wouldn't want to do that. And it will also slow down your website considerably. So just pick 6 or 7 options that users can see when they visit a specific article on your site. So once you've done that, you can just click on the Save button and go back to the previous menu. Click on Floating Sidebar. Now, this is where you can change the look and feel of your sidebar. So you'll be able to see all the social networks that you have activated here. And you can also change the look and feel of this particular social bar. You can go with the rounded option, circle, rectangle, based on what your preference is. And you can also increase the size or decrease the size of the sidebar. The next option is pretty important. So if you would like the social bar to be activated only on your blog posts, then you can pick the post option here. But if you'd like the social bar to be present on all the pages, then you can click all these options here. And you have various options to change the look and feel of your sidebar. You can also include button spacing if you feel that it looks better. You can also give an option to users to click on the plus button. This will allow them to see all the social networks, all the 30 plus social networks that are enabled on Social Snap. Or you can just remove it if you feel that it complicates matters. You can also include the total share count, and you can mention the minimum share count here. So only once it crosses that particular threshold, the share count will be mentioned. Otherwise, it will not be mentioned. So this is one way you can boost your social proof. Next, you can also tweak the color. So if you would want this sidebar to be similar to the color palette that you use on your site, you can mention the color scheme here. And this particular sidebar will be consistent with your site designs. So this is one of the USPs of Social Snap. You can change the look and feel of the sidebar to match your site design. So if you'd like to do that, you can use custom colors for your sidebar. So once you've made all the changes to make sure that the look and feel of the sidebar is as per your requirement, you can just save the changes and go back to the main menu again. The next few options are totally as per your requirement. If you would like to enable inline buttons, you can do that. You can either place it at the top of your content or below your content, or both above and below. And once again, you can change the look and feel of how your inline buttons will look. The next option is on media. This is where the Pinterest save button really comes in handy. So if you have a lot of graphics on your site, if you have a lot of infographics and you drive a lot of traffic from Pinterest, it would make sense for you to enable this option. You can also enable other share buttons. Pinterest is obviously the social network where you would want to share most of your images. But if you would like this option to be enabled on other social networks, you can activate those share buttons here. And once again, you can change the look and feel of the button. You can change the button shape, the button size, the visibility. You can keep it always visible, or you can just keep it visible when someone hovers over it. And you can also change the position of the button. So all of these options are available. Once you've made all the changes based on your needs, you can just click on Save Changes and go back to the menu once again. The next option is Share Hub. So this is what a Share Hub looks like. So if you have the sidebar enabled, then preferably you wouldn't want to enable this. You can just keep the sidebar, because then you're giving too many options to your readers and you know, they'll see social buttons everywhere. So I have disabled it, but if you'd like this to be enabled, you can do that. This is what a Share Hub is. The next option is sticky bar. So you can enable this if you would like the social share buttons to be stuck to a particular place. It'll always be either at the bottom or at the top. I find them a little too intrusive, and that's the reason I've disabled them. Plus, you already have the sidebar activated on the left side, so it wouldn't make sense for you to include this option as well, and that's why I've disabled it. A thing I forgot to mention about the floating sidebar is that you can choose to hide it on mobile devices. I've decided to hide them on mobile because they didn't look all that good. They were, once again, a little too intrusive, and I didn't want the whole mobile experience of my site to be hampered because of this. So that's the reason I've disabled it. You can choose to enable it, but if you'd like to hide it on mobile devices, then you'll have to select this particular option. So this is the social sharing aspect of Social Snap. The next is social followers. So if you would like, you can enable this. I've not enabled it now. But if you'd like to drive traffic to your social sites, to your Facebook page, to your Twitter page, or to your LinkedIn page, you can choose to do that. You can place it on a widget on your WordPress site on the right side, and you can redirect traffic to all your social channels. So you can also enable this if you want. The next option is click to tweet. You must have already seen these embedded on various publications, where there'll be a particular click to tweet section within the content itself, where the users have the option to click that particular portion of the article. You can also, you'll also find these at the top of the article or at the bottom of the article. In this case, I've placed it at the bottom of one of my articles. So this is where users have the option to tweet out your content within a particular place. So you're making it easier for people to share it on Twitter by doing this. And there is a plugin called Click to Tweet on WordPress. So if you wouldn't want an additional plugin to be installed just to enable Click to Tweet, you can do it within Social Snap itself. And each time you're working on a new article and you would like a particular snippet of the article to be tweeted out, you can just include Click to Tweet option within your article itself. So the next option is social meta. So you can enable social meta so that there is an image that is automatically picked up when someone shares your content on Twitter or on Facebook. So I would urge you to enable this option. Next, you have social identity. So if you have social followers enabled on Social Snap, and if you have this particular widget enabled, then you would have to probably give your social identity as well. You can enter your Twitter username, your Facebook URL, or your Facebook app ID, and your Pinterest username, and the social followers widget will be automatically activated with the information on your Facebook fans, your Twitter followers, and your Pinterest followers. You have a few advanced options as well. You can enable click tracking. You can enable UTM tracking. You can also do share count recovery. So if you've used any social share plugins before, and if you would like Social Snap to recover some of that share count, you can enable this option. And you can also use the Bitly URL shortener. So if you have an active Bitly account, and if you'd like the links to be automatically shortened through Bitly, you can enable this option and enter your Bitly account details here. That's about it. Once you have tweaked all the settings as per your needs, social sharing will be up and ready on your site, and you'll be making it easier for users to share your content on social media through this particular plugin. Thank you so much for watching this video. Hope you liked this Social Snap review and walkthrough. If you like this type of content, please subscribe to the channel, and you can also visit 99signals.com for more tips and insights on online marketing. Thanks once again, and I'll be back very soon.